Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, let's see a few different shapes of bricks. So generally, you know, a standard brick is rectangular in shape, but we have some different kinds of bricks which have a different shape. And let's see what are the different shapes of bricks available and what are the types of shapes, and also let's see where are they generally used. Okay, so coming to the first one, which is a bullnose brick. So bullnose brick is the brick which is molded with a rounded angle in the front. So you can see in the diagram, right, this is a bullnose brick. You can see the surface or the front part of the brick is molded in a rounded angle, okay, like a fillet shape. That's called as a bullnose brick. And these types of bricks are generally used for a rounded quoin. So rounded quoin means, you can see here in the second diagram, quoin is nothing but it's the connection between the masonry when there is a turn in the wall. Means now you can see the wall from here has come till here and another wall from here has come till here, and both of them are connected. There is no break in the continuation of the wall. So this place where the connectivity is taking place at this corner is called as a quoin. Okay. And bullnose bricks are generally used at these places. Next, we have channel bricks. So channel bricks are those bricks which are molded in the shape of a channel or in the shape of a gutter. So generally these bricks, as the name itself, they are implying that they are used for allowing something to flow above them, like water flows or gutter drainage flows, anything like that. So we generally mold the bricks into a channel shape. So you can observe in the diagram. So mainly these bricks are used for drainage purposes. Next, we have coping bricks. So coping bricks are those bricks where the coping is provided in the bricks. So coping means, you can see in the first diagram, this shape you can see. Generally, this is for done for walls, especially parapet walls, for beautification purpose. So the shape, whatever you can see, the coping could be of chamfered shape or half round shape or a saddleback shape. Okay, so these coping bricks are generally used, as told, on the topmost layer of the parapet wall. Okay, next we have hollow bricks. So you can see in the diagram, hollow bricks means they are inside the brick is hollow, means it is cellular or it is having cavity inside. That's why it is called as a cellular brick or a cavity brick. It is made up of special homogeneous clay, and also hollow bricks are light in weight. Why? Because the inside mass is completely eliminated, it's hollow. And especially hollow bricks are used in partition walls. Next, we have paving bricks. As the name itself, the bricks are used for pavement purpose. So paving bricks are also made up of clay, but with a higher percentage of iron, and also these bricks resist better abrasive action of traffic. Means when traffic is moving over the bricks, they have a good abrasion effect. Means the top surface of the bricks will not be spoiled, it will be able to take resistance. And especially the uses of these bricks are, as already told, they are used for pavement purposes. Pavement means like street pavements. You can see, observe some pavements in the parks, in the gardens, and also some floors, etc. You can use these bricks. Means generally where people are walking or when traffic is there, we can use such type of bricks, low volume traffic. Next, we have perforated bricks. So perforated bricks means they have perforations. Perforations means small cylindrical holes, or generally these bricks are used especially for multi-storied framed structures, like in the form of a panel. Okay, these bricks are not used individually, like they are used in the form of a panels, right? So perforated bricks means they have cylindrical holes, and these holes have uniform diameter. These bricks are also light in weight. Why? Because the mass, complete mass, is made up of perforations, and also they require less amount of clay, obviously. And as told earlier, uses are, they are used in panels for lightweight structures and multi-storied framed structures. That's all is about different shapes of bricks. So hope you understood the video. Thank you.